We will now take two very rapid questions on the screen up here from civil society. And I have them for you here also in written form.
Thank you very much.
My name is Angelique Pouponneau. I am from the Seychelles. I represent the Commonwealth Youth Council. My question is, what is your plan to mainstream young people in the decision-making process? Thank you.
My name is Ngendanabo, Harriet, beneficiary of Sight Savers inclusion project called Connecting the Dots. Sight Savers campaigners and I would like to ask, people with disabilities have been left out of global development discussion for too long. How will you change this?
Yes, Madam Gherman, a few comments to these questions.
Thank you very much. The first one was about youth and young people. And I do believe that we all have to make sure that whatever we do while delivering on our commitments, we have to make sure that our purposes are well understood and well known for the younger generations, because that would make the United Nations relevant for the young people, and we have to involve them in all our activities. And while talking about the youth agenda, for example, we have to be absolutely keen on providing the fair representation of the young people in absolutely all processes. We have to make sure that they take part, that they are represented at all levels, at the levels of community, local authorities, national, regional, and international. We think from the very first stages where the decent conditions for childhood have to be ensured, decent conditions and actions to the education, and very importantly, employment. That should guide our efforts. And if we are looking back into the 2030 agenda for sustainable development, and if we are serious about delivering on the provisions, objectives and targets, that would ensure very good conditions for involving our youth, because they, of course, are different, and they should be different. They think differently than we do. They act differently. They vote differently very often. And I'm far from saying that we should tell them and decide for them. They should decide for themselves. But what we have to do collectively is to make sure that we accompany them throughout their journey while they are still young. And if we are together accompanying them, then we are sure that they will be responsible citizens and they will take over from us in a very responsible manner. And the next question was about the people with disabilities, and indeed there is the sentiment that these people seem to be left behind from the development discussions and from the common actions. And if we are to deliver on 2030 agenda, as I said, with the motto that should guide our efforts, nobody should be left behind, I'm absolutely sure we owe the people with disabilities more participation, more representation. We have to be ready to listen to their plight, to what they have to say, and act accordingly in a very inclusive manner. And for this, we also need to work even closer with the civil society and with the non-governmental sector, who are able to consolidate these partnerships in this particular field. Thank you.
Thank you. We